at a certain stage into the zone of influence and let the sons of blind human beings who are the elder brothers of the animal as the masters of the wisdom or the elder brothers where humanity is concerned. So the interlocking proceeds and the division of responsibility. It. What I-S-T-H-E-V-E-L-A-T-I-O-N-E-T-W-E-N. A. The 10 planetary systems. B. D. E. F. The 7 sacred planets. The 7 chains in a scheme. The 7 globes in a chain. The 7 rounds on a globe. We have in this question a vast quantity of matter to deal with, and it would be impossible for us to do more than to get a broad and general idea. The subject is so vast and the comprehensiveness of the interrelated points is so great that we shall only attain lucidity if we confine our attention to certain broad general conceptions, leaving the subsidiary points for more detailed elucidation at some later period. 1. The interrelated parts. Primarily, I would suggest that we consider this subject only as it concerns a heavenly man, that we omit from our immediate calculations the consideration of the cellular composition of his body through separated units of consciousness which we call Deva and human. INTROVUCTORYCESTIONS 189. Beings can imagine view the matter from what is to the human being, the group concept, and not the individual. The entire middle section of this treatise on the fires has to do with the development of the consciousness of a heavenly man, and the application by him of the knowledge gained through the aid of. Monitor minds in a previous solar system, to the acquisition of wisdom through objectivity, and to the transmutation of the earlier acquired faculty into applied love. This is his work in the same sense that the work of the self within his body is to develop the mind principle. Went through experience in the three worlds that accomplish this, we can then gain through the final initiation something of the group concept, for the conscious realization of place, and of energized activity within the ring cast not of their particular planetary logos. Therefore, we might consider the following points. First, the work of the units who go to the makeup of a particular planetary logos. This is of us, threefold nature. A. To attain the consciousness of the realized control of their own individual ring cast knot, or of their own sphere of activity. This covers the period of evolution up to the first initiation, or their entrance upon the path, and thus into the spiritual kingdom. Of This covers a period in the scheme of evolution, and it's that period during the evolutionary stage which is comprised within the first three rounds up to the entrance upon the fourth round. B. To attain to the consciousness of the solar logos, within whose body they form the center. It entails the attainment by a heavenly man of a new consciousness of a sevenfold nature, for the achievement of accurate vibratory relationship with the other heavenly men who form the other center. It carries with it thus. Capacity to have full conscious control on the seven planes of the solar system, and it covers that period of development which is undergone in a planetary chain during the fourth, fifth, and sixth round. It should be borne in mind that a paralleling recognition should here be given to the fact that the solar logos holds an analogous position in the body of a cosmic entity to that held by a heavenly man. Consciousness of a greater center on cosmic level. This covers the period of the seventh round, and gives to a heavenly man when these rounds are viewed in the light of the eternal now, and not from the standpoint of time and of space to consciousness of. Yeah.